Hello everyone, today we discuss about OBG case study on postpartum hemorrhage. Let's see how to make case study on postpartum hemorrhage without wasting time. First bit of biographical data, name of patient, age, sex, occupation, address, marriage status, admission, date of admission, diagnosis, uncontrolled bleeding, estimation of blood loss, pulse rate and blood pressure measurement. Next come to second, present medical history, patient admitted in hospital with complaint of heavy bleeding after giving birth with one day of giving. It can happen up to 12 weeks after a baby. Present surgical history, patient has no surgical history in present. Past medical history, she admitted in government hospital before 5 weeks for vaginal delivery due to increased vaginal bleeding. Past surgical history, patient has past surgical history. Then it next come to the family history. This includes serial number, name of family member and patient, age, sex and relation and health status. Relation to patient, and this is normal and abnormal. Next it come to the family tree. Family tree we have to make like this. The square is male and circle is female, and circle filled with pencil is client. Now next is socioeconomic history. Patient is living in concrete house. Her family income is 10,000 per month after a relation with family and other relation. So next it come to physical examination, anthropometric measurement, weight, height, vital, temperature, pulse, respiration, general appearance, consciousness, body build, head, hair, scalp, face, visual activity, normal, lips, clear, conjunctiva, pale, ear, hearing, normal, mucous membrane, no distal, no external structure, short and septum, symmetrical. Oral cavity, lips, pink color, gums, no swelling, teeth, yellowish, neck, general structure, normal, and range of motion is also normal. Next is come to personal history. Hygiene maintained, diet vegetarian, sleep and rest, 6 hour, elimination pattern 5 to 6 time, chest and respiration, chest and shape is symmetrical, breathe sound is good, and abdomen, hair, scar and bladder absent. Next it come to the introduction of the postpartum hemorrhage is commonly defined as the blood loss exceedingly 500 ml following vaginal birth and 100 ml following cesareans. The causes of the postpartum hemorrhage: uterine atomy, retained placenta, failure of progress, second stage of labor, placenta accurate laceration, instrumental delivery, risk factor abnormality of uterine contraction, retained product and cerebral tract trauma, genital tract trauma, abnormality of coagulation. Prevention: what is the prevention? Assess each woman risk of PPH and make appropriate arrangement for the care. Routine oxytocin administration in the third stage of the labor reduce the risk of PPH. Third stage can also be include early cord, clamping cord and traction, uterine palpation and the inspection of the burn, the placenta and low genital management, early recognition of PPH and treatment. When the woman is hearing experience bleeding, the attempt to determine the cues of the bleeding while at the sense test measurement abnormality of coagulation. If is any abnormality of coagulation, the coagulation therapy should be given. Then next come to the nursing diagnosis: deficit fluid volume due to loss of excessive blood, risk of the imbalance of fluid, inactive tissue perfusion, risk for the infection, relation to vagina, acute pain due to bleeding, hemorrhage, delegate related to diet, personal hygiene. Then it next come to how to make NCP. First assessment, nursing diagnose, goal, planning, implementation, evaluation. In assessment, we have two topics, subjective data and objective data. Subjective data, patient complain. Note, she have pain in low abdomen. Objective, pain in low abdomen. Nursing, abdomen related to product of cesarean expelled through the uterus. Goal, to reduce the pain. Planning, to assess the general condition of the body, to assess the level of the pain, to provide comfortable position, administer analgesic. Implementation, general condition is assessed. Patient is level of pain is assessed. Comfortable position provided to patient. Analgesic administration to the patient. Evaluation, pain is due up to some extent evidence by patient having good sleep. Then next to assessment, nursing diagnose, goal, planning, implementation, evaluation. Subjective data, patient is feeling weak. Objective data, patient look like tired. Nursing diagnose, risk of imbalance, to give energy to the patient. Planning, assess the neurological status and the absence or any behavior change. Monitor the sign of the hypertension, direction of obese, the sign. Observe the sign of the dyspepsia, calculation for the sign. Assess the measurement of the regularities. Neurological status is assessed. Hypertension is assessed. Sign of dyspnea is assessed. Weight of the client is assessed. Patient feel good up to the some extent. Next is the assessment, nursing diagnose, goal, planning, implementation, evaluation. Subjective data, objective data. Patient complain of match, do objective. Assessment, nursing diagnose, goal, planning, implementation, evaluation. Subjective data, patient complain of match, do objective. Patient look depressed. Nursing diagnose is active intolerance related to pain and low abdomen, to improve activity. Intolerance of patient, assess the level of the intolerance. Assess the patient in daily activity. Educate the patient about the daily taking proper rest. Provide comfortable position to the patient. Level of intolerance, assess the patient daily activity, assess and educate the patient about is picked up, educated and provide comfortable position to the patient. Active intolerance reduced up to some extent. Then next come to the health education. Encourage the patient to take adequate rest and sleep. Provide calm and quiet environment. Diet, ask the client to avoid spicy food and fatty acids. Supplementary diet also import, such as iron, calcium, folic acid. Educate the mother to keep surrounding clean. So this is how you can make a case study on postpartum hemorrhage. Subject is OBG, obstetric and gynecology. Hope you get information from this video. Like the video and subscribe my channel for more video, and share this information to someone, to your friend. Thank you.